This video is based on fiction, entertainment, and education purpose. There is no relation with real life. This video does not promote or encourage any violence or illegal activity. I'm not trying to offend or insult anybody through this video. We are not responsible for any misuse of the information. Assalamu alaikum viewers. Today I'm going to show you how to set Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 controls on PC Windows 10. All necessary links are given in the description, so just follow me. Before moving forward, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to keep updated with my latest videos. And note that watch my complete video for 100% result. So first I'm going to launch my game. And also connect my Xbox 360 wireless controller. And I run my game on window mode to show you both keyboard and gamepad controls. Run as administrator, yes. And note one thing here, if you use gamepad first to skip the tutorial, then your gamepad consider your P1 control and it will use in your menu settings. If you use a first keyboard to skip tutorial, then your keyboard will consider P1 control and it will use in your menu settings. Here. Press A, okay, and checking installing now. Okay, now here for keyboard settings, if you want to go keyboard settings, then you need to press back of your gamepad. Okay, it will work for keyboard settings, and by default in this game for keyboard settings press button is set backspace, but because you initially use your gamepad keys to skip the video and you use as P1 control your gamepad, so backspace will not work for keyboard settings. Here I am now pressing backspace, but it will not work for keyboard settings. So I am press backspace and now it will show keyboard settings. Okay, I'm going to again show you. Again, launch my game and show you that now the same method is work for now keyboard and not with the work with gamepad. Suppose I am now first use with the keyboard to skip the video. Okay, now I am using keyboard controls and it will consider a P1 control. Okay, and all the settings will work with keyboard. Okay, I am using L use to skip. Press L. And now here I'm using keyboard as my P1 control, so now backspace will work. Here you can see that I want to go back, and now for example I'm going to press back of my gamepad. It does not work with keyboard setting for keyboard setting. Okay, so I hope you understand that for P1 controls the game consider P1 control of keyboard and gamepad just when you initially use which controls you are using, keyboard or gamepad. So after that understanding this thing, now I'm going to first set keyboard controls. Okay, so for keyboard control I'm just press backspace, and here for back I'm using press my L button. And now I ask for set, so I'm going to set F. And for start, I'm going to press L to select. Now I'm going to press H. Okay, H I think. And now for game D-pad controls, here up, down, left, right. So I'm going to use. Okay, let this remain same. And first I'm going to show. This controls, and for me I'm going to set Y for my J, and for A press L, and now keep remains same L, and for X I'm going to set I, and for B I'm going to set K, and now for LB I'm going to set LB for shift, and LT I'm going to use and set RB, for RB I set semicolon, and for RT I'm going to set control, left control, okay, left control, RT, and for RS the button of right analog, RS press right analog inside, so I set E, and for L left analog press inside, for I set L, sorry, Q. For this key I set 4, okay. For LC I set Q, okay, I set Q, and now for move up down I use WASD by default, okay, it remains same, left analog key, left analog keys I remain same, WASDF, and right analog I want to change right analog, and for right analog I set right analog up, and right analog down, and right analog left remain same, okay, and right analog right. So these are the keys for me, and for num d-pad controls I set num 8 and down for num 2 and num 4 for left, and num 6 for right, okay, of d-pad, okay. So these are my keys for gamepad keyboard, and if I click on press L, now go to setting complete and press L, confirm, and now press for save, press H, I set H for start, so it's necessary to save your setting, okay, and now press L, now it save your settings for keyboard, and now press again A for confirm, and now gamepad controls are remain same for me, and default keys okay for me. So I'm going to press J, go to option, and now control settings, and go to press A, and here you can see that P1 control on your left side, these are the P1 controls, and press start button, and here you can see that I press start button of my gamepad, and it will show on right side the P2 control, okay, player 2 controls here, and now I press A, and also for set complete settings, settings complete, press A, and now it's saving, saves, and go back. Now gamepad doesn't work because I initially used keyboard as P1, so now I need to again use keyboard, and here going back, press K, go back, and now I show you some gameplay for both controls, okay, for gamepad and keyboard, for free battle here two players, press A, L for confirm, and now versus battle, confirm, and now I want to select P1 versus P2, and now confirm, now select your character, I just randomly select one from P1, this is my keyboard controls, and now I'm going to select, press start first, and now select the gamepad control P2, my force history, select similar set to characters, and now select the destination bar we want. And now I'm first going to use keyboard controls, and here you can see that my keyboard controls are working fine. And now I'm going to use now I'm going to use a gamepad, my Acoustics controller, and here you can see that my gamepad controls are working fine. I hope you enjoy the tutorial. If you find any problem, tell me in the comments. Please like and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.